Welcome back to Let's Play Clannad. Last time we finished up and did April 17th, and today we're looking at April 18th. I realize in, I believe, like, part 3/4 of April 17th, I think it's, yeah, part 3, I realized I was reading really fast, and I apologize for that. I'm gonna work on not reading so fast, hopefully in the 18th. I was in post-editing, I was just like, wow, I was really reading that fast and just flying by this, and, you know, probably something I shouldn't have done during those interactions, but oh well. Without further ado, let's get into it. Rays from the morning sun spill into my room, my eyes singed by the ultraviolet glow. Ah, why did I wake up this early? I could still make it to school with plenty of time to spare. Well, it's not like I'm late to school because I want to be. I get out of bed and throw some clothes on, getting my day started a little earlier than usual. Stepping over my snoring father's body, I make my way through the living room and out the door. This is a strange sight. Flocks of students from my school are walking about. Then again, this is what it's supposed to be like.
Ohayo!
Good morning!
Ohayo!
Morning! Greetings pass through the air as I stand there, but not a single person says hello to me. They all just walk by with smiles on their faces. I'm probably invisible to all of them. Which would also mean that if I were to just turn around and wander off, then no one would stop me. Maybe I'll just run off somewhere. Where are you going? Someone tugs on my sleeve. So, someone can see me after all. Whoever it is, they must be like me. Another inhabitant of this invisible world. Okazaki-san, school is this way. Oh, you're right. I had it wrong. How could you get that wrong? Everyone's walking in the same direction. Yeah, and seeing them do that makes you want to go to the exact opposite way. But you just can't. You'll finally be on time for once. Let's just go together. Going to school side by side with a girl in this big of a crowd? Just the thought of it is enough to send a shiver down my spine. You go on ahead. Nope, I won't do that. If you're not going, I'm waiting right here too. You'll be late for class. That's fine with me. We stay there for a while, and the number of students walking to school begins to visibly shrink. We're getting pretty tight on time. We can still make it if we go now. Oh yeah?
Hi.
Yes. Aren't we invisible anyway? Aren't we so unattractive and unimportant that no one would bother to pay attention to us in the first place? Let's hurry.
Hi.
Yes. Midway up the hill, I see a girl standing there, staring into the sky. It's a face I recognize, making me stop instinctively. What's the matter, Okazaki-san? Is that a friend of yours? No, not really. Let's go. Sunohara comes to school right when first period ends. Hey, morning. You're early today too, huh? Of course. I can't just let it end like this. He puts down his bag. Let's go and get revenge! He nimbly turns around. You can't beat her, you know. And like I said, revenge is revenge. It's only if I fight her directly. It's not like I plan to have an honest fight. There are many different ways to win, if you just use your head. Why don't you use your head for studying instead? Just hear me out. I've got a great idea. Walk with me and I'll explain. Tsunohara says as he walks out of the classroom. Come with me, man! He came back. What now? getting tired of you. Well, just hear me out. I've got a great idea. Walk with me and I'll explain. Quit repeating yourself. My plan is psychological warfare. Don't try so hard to use complicated words. They're not complicated at all! Listen carefully, alright, Okazaki? He grips my shoulder firmly, urging me. Alright, I'll listen. So let me go. You're creeping me out. Why is she so serious to begin with? That's what I've been thinking about. Once again, he starts walking. And what was your conclusion? It's a man. What? In the end, she's just another girl. She must have started showing some interest in the opposite sex since she's that age. In other words, she came to the school in order to find a wonderful boyfriend. Couldn't she just find one at her old school? Maybe, but wouldn't she prefer one who's intelligent and has good prospects for the future? She's already thinking about the future, huh? And so, males are all she can think about, meaning that those are a weak point. So, concretely, what are you up to? Seduce her. I'll just butter her up and have her dance in the palm of my hand. With that, she'll be in a weakened state and she won't be able to fight anymore. You're an idiot, aren't you? Why? Isn't that a great plan? Well, you can do whatever you want, I guess.
Yeah.
No, that just won't do. Because this is where you come in. What? Aren't you two pretty close? Compared to you, at least. In that case, give me some hints on how I can woo her and make her weak. Yeah, this guy really is an idiot. Anyone would be able to get a girlfriend without any trouble if that was actually attainable knowledge. I mean, we're probably just gonna give him some fake advice anyway, so here you go, dude. However, it sounded like it would be fun, so I accepted. Well, if you insist, then I guess I have no choice.
Oh, 頼む! うまくやってくれよ! マジで!
Yes, please do. Make sure it goes well, alright? And be serious about it. We end up in front of classroom 2B. Tsunohara stops a girl who's trying to enter the classroom and asks her to go get Tomoyo. After a short while, Tomoyo shows up. What? You again? Haven't you had enough already? She looks at Tsunohara with her narrowed eyes. No, today's different. The way I view you has completely changed. What do you mean? First, say something nice about how she's dressed. I look the other way, whispering something to Tsunohara so only he can hear it. That thing you have on your head looks nice on you. Oh, really? Thank you. Next, compliment how she looks in her uniform. And your uniform looks really good on you, too. Oh, really? Thank you. But actually, you're creeping me out here. She's feeling embarrassed. Things are looking good. You just gained 30 affection points. What kind of number is that even supposed to be? Alright, next up. Stretch your arms and say, "Ah, you must be quite popular with all the boys since you're so beautiful." Make it sound natural. That's not natural at all. Just say it if you can. Damn it all. Hmm? What's wrong?
Yeah, こっちの話.
No, just mumbling to myself. Tsunohara takes a deep breath. It looks like he's It looks like he actually plans on saying it. He starts stretching out.
Ah, Tomoyoってこんなに美人だからモテるんだろうな.
Ah, you must be quite popular with all the boys since you're so beautiful.
Just
what is all of this? I don't know whether you're honestly complimenting me or whether you're just ridiculing me. I don't know how, but the results are even better than one could imagine.
マジかよ.
Seriously? Next up, while doing Hindu squats, say, "Ah, I'm actually kinda desperately seeking a girlfriend right now." Make it natural. Isn't it completely unnatural to be saying that while doing a Hindu squat? For Tomoyo, that's completely natural. Seriously? What are you talking about? Nothing, just mumbling to myself. Tsunohara takes a deep breath. He's seriously gonna do it. He starts vigorously doing Hindu squats. Actually, I'm kinda desperately seeking a girlfriend right now. No, wait, doesn't that line sound totally weird? Just say it. And don't you think that sentence itself was strange? Don't sweat such small stuff. Because of you, it had no effect at all. So it's my fault? If you have no business with me, I'm leaving. Good. This is the critical moment. Take off your pants in order to lure her back.
Yes.
Alright. Wait, no way I'm doing that. You two are quite the strange ones, aren't you? Alright, let's use the killer pickup line then. I've been waiting for this. Say, "Tomoyo-san, from now on, please make me breakfast every morning while striking a bowling pose."
Yes.
Alright. Tsunohara mimes holding a bowling ball to his chest. He then strides forward for a few steps and throws the ball in beautiful form.
Tomoyo-san, これから毎朝, 僕の朝食を作ってください!
Tomoyo-san, from now on, please make me breakfast every morning. Wait, is there even any meaning to this pose? No, not really. Then don't make me do it! What? So you really were just ridiculing me. She knows. Guess it can't be helped. First one to strike wins! Tsunohara dashes toward her. Tsunohara comes flying toward me due to the force of Tomoyo's kicks. Third page of saves, here we go. I'll dodge. I casually move out of the way. He slides across the corridor and crashes head first into the wall. He immediately gets back up and double times it over back over here. I almost died there! Wow, you're actually fine!
Hey, Anata.
Hey, you! A girl starts to approach Tomoyo. Me?
So, Anata, 部活入ってる?
Yes, you. Are you in a club yet?
いや、入っていないが...
No, I'm not.
やった!じゃあ、柔道しましょう! ね?
Yes! Why don't you join the judo club then? How about it? Oops. It appears that she knows Tomoyo's reflexes, and now she's trying to recruit her. If we have you, we might even be able to go for the championship. You have such exceptional talent. No thanks. She answers coldly and tries to leave.
そんな、待ってよ。
Don't say that. Wait up!
入らないって言っている。
I told you I'm not joining.
すぐにとは言わないから。
I'm not telling you to join immediately, just...
くどいぞ。
Quit being so persistent. The two walk down the corridor as they quarrel.
いい気になりやがって。
That conceited bitch. To me, it looked like you were just causing her trouble again, though.
ああいうの天狗って言うんだよ。
What she's doing is called showing off.
次会った時には覚えておけよ。
You're gonna regret this next time we meet. She can't hear you, you know. Lunchtime. We're eating bread in our usual spot.
2週間後一人でも来てくれるでしょうか?
2 weeks from now. I wonder if anyone at all will show. 2 weeks from now. That's when the drama club information session is going to be held. Well, the flyers do have the big Dango family on them. I hesitate for a moment, unable to answer.
Okazaki-san?
Okazaki-san? I'm sure it'll be fine.All those dango you released around the school are sitting on their billboards. Hard at work. Have some faith.
ですよね。100人もいるんですから。
You're right. There's as many as 100 of them after all. I think that's actually our problem. I make a quiet dig at Furukawa's extreme confidence. But seriously, why were those so popular to begin with? Looking back on it, it doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Though, it makes even less sense to still to be...Sense to still be a fan of them.
そういえば、岡崎さん。
Speaking of which... What?
説明会って何をすればいいものなんでしょうか?
What kind of things do you do at an information session?
岡崎さん?
岡崎さん? I'd forgotten. She's not the kind of person who can just rise to the occasion and take care of this kind of thing on her own. Furukawa?
はい。
Yes?Let's do some practice right now. Talk about whatever you want. I sit on the ground and give the instructions to Furukawa, who's standing in front of the chalkboard. She seemed to have some degree of awareness that she was the club leader, so she'd taken the initiative and decided to stand there. If this were just a few days ago, she probably would have asked me to stand there in her place. She's really trying to be proactive about doing this. It's clear that this means a lot to her. Her actions confirm that. You can do this, Furukawa!I cheer her on inside my head. But... well... Instead of starting her speech, she just waves her hands to and fro, visibly squirming. At this rate, the first bell is gonna chime before she even gets started. Hey, Furukawa.Yes. Looking at you now, it makes you wonder, how are you able to act in plays? If she's this bad at talking and this susceptible to pressure, can she really expect prospective club members to take her seriously? I mean, who wants to join a drama club with a president that can't even overcome her nerves? Talk about a blatant discrepancy. So essentially, these phantom theoretical applicants would be faced with not one, but two glaring problems. First, the big Dango family obsession, obviously.And second, a president who can't talk. And those aren't exactly small, easy to overlook qualms, either. Not like that they would want to overlook them in the first place.
Okazaki-san?
Let me be straight up with you, Furukawa.
Hi.
Okay. You don't have any acting skill. So you're gonna need to try like crazy.Alright. Which means you're gonna need to practice for the information session for a while. And I do mean a while. Okay, I'll do my best. She balls her hands into fists. At least she seems motivated.
Tomoya!
Hmm? Yo.
Doko itte ta no?
Where did you go? Just running an errand. Could it be this? She raises her pinky and grins. It's nothing Lonnie like that. Hmm? You seem tired. I guess I might actually be a pretty caring guy. What's this? Should I be laughing? Yeah, go ahead and laugh. Quit laughing! Sheesh, you told me it was okay to laugh, and now you're mad. You're such a pain. Oh, welcome back. Huh? You're here. Is that any way to greet me? You make it sound like I shouldn't be here. Well, you really shouldn't be. You're an eyesore. The only thing you accomplish here is producing carbon dioxide, right? Even weeds are better because they produce oxygen. You guys say some pretty harsh things! Before that, Kyo Fujibayashi, why are you here? What? You're saying I can't be here? That's not really what I meant. Since the first bell is already rung, I thought it'd be better if you went back to your own class. The second bell still hasn't rung yet, has it? It shows what a small person you are when you bring up such trivial things. Small? Me? I would say this around the size of a water flea.
Plankton!
Plankton? Hey, water flea. What's going on over there? Hey, what? What do you mean? I actually responded to that. Whatever, just answer me. I'm talking about the group of people over there. Not that I know whose seat that is. That one should be the class president's. Fujibayashi's? Is there something we need to turn in? Oh, that? I bet it's her fortune telling. Fortune telling? Still, it's as popular as ever. What is? Ryo's fortune telling. You mean the class presence in the center of that crowd? Yep. Are her fortunes that accurate? I guess she does have something that she's good at, even though it doesn't seem like it. Ow! What was that for? I won't forgive anyone for insulting my sister. I was praising her! That hurts! Your grades in language class are terrible, right? He fails every exam. How could you possibly know that? I saw them in your room. I found a bunch of them when I was fishing under your desk. Do I not have any privacy at all? Check this guy out. He's concerned about that now. I know, right? You two are weird. Oh, yeah. Hey, loser. Who are you calling loser? Since you responded, wouldn't that be you? It could have been you. No, I meant you. Is that so? So, what is it? How about you let Ryo tell you your fortune? Me? Tomoya's done it a couple times too, right? Hmm? Yeah, I guess. So what does she use in her fortune telling? What does she use? Well... Do I pick the choice for the sake of comedy? I did say this was a pretty serious read. But at the same time... Lend me your ear.
何?そんな人前じゃ言えないような占いなの?
Eh, what's the matter? Is there something you can't say out loud? Just do it.
ん?
え、
マジ?
Seriously?
あ、あの人だかりの中心部で…そんな…
She's doing something like that in the middle of the crowd? No way!
しかも生で?
Naked too!
っていうか、岡崎お前何度もしてるの?
That aside, how many times have you done, Okazaki? I give Sunohara, whose eyes are wide open, a thumbs up.
Kyo, お前の妹すごいよ!
Kyo, your sister's amazing!
え?
Huh?
おとなしいと思ってたけど、実はすごい大胆な子なんすね!
トモヤ、あんた傭兵に何言ったの?
ぼ、僕もちょっと占い、
okay.
してもらってくるよ!
I think we're good. Don't hate me for it.I think we are all inherently a bit curious as to what exactly would have been said. And I mean, come on. Did you really think he'd say that out loud? You little deviants, you. She uses cards. That doesn't sound like it's very effective to me. She gets awfully specific with them, though. I'm sure it'll be useful. You sure? Yeah!
So, okay.じゃあ行ってみようかな。
I see. Let's give it a try then. Sunohara enthusiastically walks toward the crowd, as Kyo and I see him off while smiling. Hey, Kyo. I say to her, with my eyes still fixed on Sunohara's back and my smile plastered on my face.
何?
Yeah. Likewise, Kyo responds while watching Sunohara walk away. I think I'm starting to understand how your sister's fortunes work.
でしょうね。
Is that so? I wonder what kind of fortune that loser's gonna get.
どう転んでも面白そうよね。
No matter what the outcome is, I'm sure it'll be fun. You're enjoying this, aren't you?
あんたもでしょ?
Aren't you too? Well, yeah. With our passionate gazes fixed on his back, Sunohara continues forward.
ほら、お前らどけ!
Alright, move it! He chases away the crowd, steps in front of Fujibayashi. He then sits down at the desk in front of hers. She really uses playing cards, huh?
まあね。
Well, yeah. Wouldn't she be better off using tarot cards?
あの子…タロットは持ってないから。
She doesn't have any tarot cards. Is that so? As Sunohara stares at Fujibayashi, shuffles her deck of cards and drops them. Flustered, she starts to pick the cards up. She then forms a fan with the cards, and Sunohara picks out three cards. Fujibayashi stares at the three cards and then says something to Sunohara. After she finishes, he nods. Looks like he received a good fortune.
のようね。
Seems like it.
聞いてくれよ!
Guys, listen! Guess the pathetic clown is back.
ピエロ? 何のこと?
Clown? What do you mean? Nah, don't worry about it. So, how'd it go?
ああ、もう最高だぜ!
Yeah, it was awesome!
これまでの辛い生活に終止符が打たれるでしょう!
Your life of hardships will soon come to an end.
恋の始まりが新しい生活の始まり!
The beginning of love will mark the beginning of a new life.
これから出会う異性とは運命の赤い糸で結ばれています。
You will soon meet someone of the opposite sex, bound to you by the red string of fate. We haven't had one of these entries in a long while. Red string of fate. The Chinese and Japanese believe that those who are fated by the gods to meet are tied to one another by a red string. In Japanese legends, this is generally depicted by a string tied around one's little finger.It's what she told me! Guess my fortune's looking rosy! He says and smiles in satisfaction. Kyo and I look at each other. Although we didn't plan it, we both pat him on the shoulder at the same time. Huh? What's this? What's wrong? Good luck. I'm sure the future is something you can change with your own hands.
なんかよくわからないけど、thank you!
I don't really get it, but thanks! He gives us a thumbs up along with a bright smile. He's playing the part of the clown very well. How pitiful. Yeah. Hmm? Come again? Nothing, don't worry about it. Oh yeah, I'm going to the bathroom, Okazaki. You want to tag along? Go by yourself.
なんだよ、釣れないな。スレションは友情の証だろ?
Jeez, that's so cold of you. Isn't going to the bathroom together proof of our friendship? There's There's no point in going if nothing's gonna come out, right?
それもそうだね。じゃあ一人で行ってくるよ。
I guess that's true. I'm going myself then. Have fun! Sunohara gleefully accepts the results of his fortune and walks out of the classroom with a strangely prideful look on his face. His back looks darker than normal, likely hinting at his grim future. The beginning of love will mark the beginning of a new life, huh?
ねえ、ところでさ、あんたって誰か好きな子いんの?